It's no.
Imagine a cleaner, greener, more beautiful city where residents are healthier and happier. This, you may not feel, is a possibility, but it is. My name is Yemiya Bilye, and today I'm going to present how this cleaner, greener, more beautiful city is possible by making this a biophilic city. Today I'm going to review, what are the health benefits of nature? What are pollution in our cities? What is biophilia and biophilic design? And how can we address the issue of pollution and improving health with biophilic design? Let's get started. To begin, how do you feel looking at this space versus this space? One is bare and devoid of life, while the other is lush, green, and vibrant with plants and life. How would you feel standing in this space? If you said calmer, you are not alone. Research says that nature makes us healthier and happier and less stressed. In fact, in the studies, the cognitive benefits of interacting with nature by Mark Berman and John Jonitis, published in the Journal of Psychological Science in December of 2008, and the effect of forest bathing tips on human immune function by Qing Li, published in the Journal of Environmental Health and Preventive Medicine in January of 2010, the author stated that nature, one, improves short-term memory, two, restores mental energy, three, is a stress reliever, four, reduces inflammation, five, improves our vision, six, improves our concentration, seven, promotes sharper thinking and creativity, eight, has possible anti-cancer effects, nine, boosts our immune system, 10, overall improves our mental health, and 11, reduces our risk of early death. Pollution is defined as the introduction of contaminants into the natural environment that cause adverse change. It can be chemical substances, energy, noise, heat, or light. These adverse substances can cause health effects such as chronic and acute respiratory illnesses like asthma or lung cancer, circulatory diseases like heart disease and strokes, increased inflammation, other cancers, and even death. In fact, in the article Pollution, Health, and the Planet, Time for Decisive Action by Pamela Das and Richard Horton, published in Lancet in October of 2017, the authors estimated that 9 million premature deaths are due to pollution in 2015 alone. And this number may be higher. Biophilia. Biophilia, as defined by Professor Edward O. Wilson, is human possessed innate tendency to seek connections with nature and other forms of life. Biophilic design is a solution to reducing pollution and improving our health. Biophilic design is an innovative way of designing the places where we live, work, and learn. It focuses on aspects of nature and the natural world that contributes to human health and productivity. Examples of biophilic design are, one, adding nature into our spaces. This includes sunlight, fresh airflow, potted plants, green walls filled with plants, and aquariums. Another example of a biophilic design is our natural analogs, which are shapes, patterns, and colors reminiscent of natural forms, natural materials like timber and stone, or nature photography and artwork. Another example of a biophilic design is nature in our space in the form of our spatial configurations, such as a cozy secluded nook, or a wide open expansive space to resemble a landscape. A biophilic city is a city with abundant opportunity for residents to be outside and to enjoy the multi-sensory aspect of nature within the city. There are cities that incorporate nature and biophilic design. Common examples are planting more trees, developing gardens. Other less common examples are establishing green rooftops or green walls along buildings. Since biophilic design can improve our health and reduce pollution, I am calling on the city to increasingly make our city a biophilic city by 1, planting more trees in communities that have less tree coverage, 2, giving tax credits to businesses to establish green rooftops, and 3, establishing more public green space for residents. We can agree that improving health and reducing pollution is a benefit to the city. Other healthy benefits to incorporating nature are reducing the urban heat island effect and managing stormwater runoff and regulating building temperature. Now, my opponents say that incorporating biophilic design is cost prohibitive in terms of installation and maintenance. But the money invested will be reaped in the near future in health savings to the city and infrastructure savings in regards to reduced damage created from storms. Thus, I'm asking for the health, safety, beauty, and vitality of our city that we love, that we invest in making our city increasingly a biophilic city. To recap, I discussed what are the benefits of nature, pollution in our cities, what is biophilia and biophilic design, how can we address the issue of pollution and improve well-being with biophilic design. I hope you contact your city council and urge them to support legislation that promotes biophilia and nature in our cities. Thank you. My name is Yamia Billiard.